As a certified relaxation technician, I'm here to prescribe my new record on compact disc, Doodad. It'll bend your mind and realign your spine with swampadelic Mississippi modern animalistic rock and roll bop. So if you're sick of hunk rock, corporate rock, powder puff metal, pick up on Doodad. Look for my movie, Horror Hayride, and come see Webb Wilder live in your town. Doodad, pick up on it. Who is Webb Wilder? Webb Wilder is the last of the full-grown men, the last of the boarding house people, a man who feels as though he's on the wrong side of the tracks no matter where he's at, a man who was never a child and will never have children, a guy who knows every plate lunch joint and thrift shop in town. Webb Wilder is an electrifying artist, the idol of idle youth, and a man haunted by flying saucers. So join us on a swampadelic, psychotronic, hillbilly gothic horror hayride.
That old deceiver don't want you to have this well, brother. His breath is frost, his touch is fever, and his eternal enemy is that one who gives the water. I'm speaking of the Lord. Anybody can dig a hole. Dig here.
Roadblock, Webb.
Not again.
I told you. You get one of those cellulite phones, we wouldn't be having all these roadside meet and greet sessions.
I'm tired of this. It's every morning. Oh, Webb.
Oh. Don't get your panties in a wad.
What'd this guy do?
Well, he saved the governor's bacon a couple of times. Helped put a rubber stamp truck driving school out of business. Webb's good people.
You mean? The one and only.
Cool.
Need a toothbrush?
Probably.
Oh, Travis. Arvid, give me my toothbrush.
The man owes you one, now he's gonna owe you two.
He ain't fishing again, is he? He knows I can't swim.
Running around the whole business there.
You mean?
Morning, boys.
Morning, Governor.
You know Carlsbad Devereaux?
Don't know who don't. No moaning at the cross by heart.
Well, that's mighty kind.
Carlsbad, you know Special Agent Travis Byrd, Department of Public Safety? Webb, what do you know about the picture business?
A little.
What's to know? It's run by more of the same Helen Kellers that run the country music industry. Couldn't hear a chainsaw, much less a hit. Doubt they could see one either.
Well, the state's making a new driver's ed movie. Hopefully one that's more relevant to modern rural teens. You know, the muscle car, street sign shooting set.
We've all been down that road.
Well, it ain't like there ain't a need for it, and I'm bound and determined it'll get the attention of the little asphalt happy bastards. But there's a hitch.
Tell it.
Kirsten.
She out of Peabody?
Oh, BA, communications. Thank you, Lordy.
Congratulations.
Yeah, she's my baby, and I'm proud of her, even if it took 8 years for a four-year degree.
Who's counting?
Well, it's her first job out of school, and she's in charge of making this movie for me.
So?
So I want to let her alone, you know, let her do it on her own, be her own person. She's hired this director.
Art monster, film school, intellectual smart butt.
It's all I can do to keep the entire Department of Public Safety from whipping his ass.
Hell, what's holding you back?
Well, Kirsten says he's good. People just don't understand his work.
But the guy's a damn pervert.
I don't know about that. Look, that's my problem. I don't have a clue. You're the only man I know that somehow maintains the respect and admiration of reckless teens and the highway patrol. You know the entertainment monkey business. And you could interface with the Legion of State Task Forces with their pitiful self-interest exposed in a film such as this.
Sounds about as fun as a root canal.
Look, she's my little girl, Webb, and it ain't all fun being the governor's daughter. She's got to make her mark, but hell, I want to help her. It's selfish, I know, but that's it. If Travis tells her that you're on the project, she'd be glad to have you. And you can look out for me.
And that's it? That's the only reason you want me?
Well, I said it was selfish. Travis says you could do some music, too, but that's up to you.
Well, I gotta take care of the man.
Good. Look, Carlsbad me got a date with a frying pan.
What's the name of the picture?
What?
The name of the movie.
Oh, Horror Hayride.
I flipped the Good Governor's rap over a dozen times on the way back to Music City, Nashville, Nash Vegas, if you will. After a grueling tour schedule taking my sonic sounds to the loving public, I wasn't too wild about squandering my quality time babysitting the governor's daughter in her little driver's ed movie. But the Gov was okay for an authority figure. Plus, if Travis Byrd was involved, some kind of something had to be going on. Travis Byrd, the only undercover highway patrolman in the whole volunteer state, the guy out there on the knuckle end of the long arm of the law, cool as an October breeze. But something had rattled his cage. It didn't take much arm twisting to get him to pipe up.
It's that film snot. He's into cursing for $5,000 a week.
What?
Look, it's between me, you, and one guy in the DPS office.
The governor don't know?
Hell no. He don't need to either. He's worried enough as it is.
Dope.
He wouldn't need that much, but I tell you, we just don't know. All we do know is that Kirsten's been raiding her mother's trust fund weekly since she took on this auteur.
Travis Byrd, I believe you're jealous.
Well, I've known Kirsten long enough to care about her, if that's what you mean. And her daddy sure doesn't deserve to be smacked by whatever it is that's smelling funny when it hits a fan.
Still sounds funny. It ain't a crime to give away dinero. Maybe it just likes money. Who don't? The question is, can he make movies? 2.5 hours of a Tarkovsky ripoff. Bones in the Kudzu left me visually stimulated but cold. The second opus, Slug Trail, seemed to be a breakthrough. The artifice of technique gave way to richer subtleties of character and metaphor, a veritable feast of texture and nuance. I gave it a thumb up. Travis only offered a finger.
The classroom is a very fragile environment. Pedagogical intercourse mishandled may often result in premature fissure in the learning process. I submit that the warped, satanic, hallucinogenic images conjured up by Mr. Briley Parkway constitute just the kind of subversive messages that both shatter the learning environment and pervert the original intent of the film.
Pervert, I think, is the operative word here. As representative of your Librarians Association...
Oh, hush up! You two biddies prattle away on your own time. As director of the Driver's Ed Association, I must completely have...
Ladies, gentlemen, this is Mr. Webb Wilder. I've asked him to serve as team liaison consultant for the Highway Patrol in this project. Webb, this is Mr. Fry of the Driver's Ed Association. Ms. Wig of the Library Association.
I believe I've heard your song, Who Do Which.
Thank you, ma'am.
Dr. Barbara Slovine of the State Psychiatrical Council.
We've met.
Let's let Mr. Wilder in on our little clip of the work in progress, shall we?
Roll it, Skeeter.
That looked like it hurt.
At this point in the movie, Briley wants this thrown in the audience.
Cute trick.
Dismemberment is not cute.
No, it's disgusting, Mr. Fry. Something you know quite a lot about. However, it's also effective. Which I guess is more of a mystery.
You vapid, shallow, narcissistic, congenitally misinformed, moronic, Napoleonic fop.
Hold on a minute. Did you do that?
Yes.
Excuse us.
There's that scene where they show the reflection of the movie on the town square wall.
Boy, that gets me.
Yeah. The old man, a saint. You gotta love him. More tater tots?
No. Fine.
What's it like to piss off every government agency in the state?
It's fulfilling, in a way.
You must be pretty fulfilled.
It comes with the territory.
I hear you. Fry and his committee would have only shown Donny Osmond from the waist up.
They don't want a movie. They want a cure for insomnia.
Look. Just keep doing what you're doing. I'll keep the heat off. Just do me a favor.
Name it.
Don't mess with Travis. He's looking for an excuse to kill you.
Webb! Briley. You boys, I showed up at the task force meeting and y'all had already left. I think the others are still sitting there.
Still early.
Webb, I'm so happy you're going to be helping us.
Anything for you, Cabbage.
Are you going to be at the party later on tonight?
What? Cast and crew party the Smokies are throwing over Carlsbad's.
Casual attire?
Is that casual?
Pick up on it.
You're sitting pretty in your XKE, long legs burning on the alligator seats. Now I don't care where we're going, I sure like the view. If I can make you mine, I'd be sitting pretty too. Won't need no mansion, you got one of those. Won't need to seek my fortune, you got three or four. Won't have to go in the hop a new diamond ring. What can you give the girl who's got everything? Now, I ain't no blue blood, ain't got the model's touch, but I'll give you love good as gold. Now, I ain't no highbrow, but I've got the know-how. I'll be the one toy you can't afford to lose.
Sitting pretty, sitting pretty,
you're sitting pretty. You're sitting pretty in the driver's seat. Ain't no sweat, babe, for me to turn up the heat. I'll be working on getting right next to you. In no time at all, I'll be sitting pretty too.
We don't do retail.
What?
Now you got a wholesale number. That's something different.
What if I do?
Well, you might want to check out some of our new inventory.
Like what?
Well, like 12 folks at 12 Oaks, The South Will Rise Again, or my personal favorite, Backstage at the Grand Ole Orgy.
What are you talking about?
You don't have a wholesale number, do you?
What has Briley Parkway got to do with this?
Well, you're gonna have to talk to Billy C. about that. He's right in there. Let me get a hold of him for you. We don't do retail, do we, Billy C.?
Yourself together, man.
How'd I get here?
Police found you beside a recycling bin outside Twitty City. You were scaring the tourists, so they called me.
Ouch.
Who adjusted your hat size?
Some greasy. I fell.
Right. Maybe next time you trip on a damn 38.
Happens. I'm pretty clumsy.
Just tell me what you want on the tombstone. Rock hard, sleep hard, grow big, wear glasses if you need them, and die stupid.
You're a smart guy. You figure it out.
I just don't want to be the one to ID the stiff, that's all.
Travis, you brought me in on this case. Now, how about some space to do the work? When I get the skinny on this, you'll be the first to know. Till then, bite a bullet.
You'll call for backups?
No, I'll just call for you.
We'll be right back.
Moaning at the Cross buys a pretty groovy pad.
That's Nashville, man.
You see, girls, that's the secret of the country music business. You can take the boy out of the holler, but you can't take the holler out of the boy. And me, well, I've been hollering all my life.
Call Ben.
Lord, my prayers have been answered. Come here to me, you good-looking thing. Girls, now, don't fret now. There's more than enough to go around, if you know what I mean. Come on, let's make a dead roll sandwich.
My, you look good.
Well, I have to agree with you, darling, but you girls are prettier than any picture an artist could draw.
You were very much the diplomat at the task force screening, Webb. I was surprised by your appreciation of the significance of Riley's work.
I was kind of surprised myself. Well, Picasso was a rude twerp, too. Made some pretty pictures, though.
Yeah, he also said there were two kinds of women, goddesses and doormats.
He'd obviously never been to Music City. Even ugly girls are good looking here. And Dr. Barber, you show as hell ain't no doormat.
I'm glad you still think so, Webb. I miss us.
Damn it, lady, you were the one who broke up the whole...
I know. But you were always traveling. And when you were home, I was going deaf.
I've got a box guitar for practicing now.
How are the dreams?
Still kicking ass and taking names.
I still think I could help you, if you'd let me.
I'm about ready to try anything.
What we need is an earring. About a little of this.
Excuse me, Dr. Barber.
What's the matter, brother? Somebody bad-mouthed Ernest Tubb or something?
Worse. It's one thing to have some hairball run down Elvis. I mean, I'm just about shit sick of Elvis jokes. But to have him blow reefer in my face while he's doing it.
Let it go. Let it go. I know this one, Travis. It's a misdemeanor. Hairball won't do it anymore. Will you, hairball? If it wasn't for fat old dad Elvis Presley, none of you would ever heard of Jimi Hendrix or Peter and Gabriel or Dove's Witness Shame or whoever the hell it is that floats your boat. Thank you. Makes me sick. One, two, one, two, three, four. Well, there's about 10 billion people who back me up on this. From the Bispo post toe digger to the rocket scientist. Hell, I bet you can't find a preacher who don't like burning love. And your band's a bunch of weak sisters if they can't play Rip It Up.
Now every two-bit tabloid had bad things to say. From New York City to La La Land, while in his state he lay. Well, if you don't think he paid for his sins, try paying for a few of your own. Your serpent tongues can't reach him. He's at peace in his heavenly home.
And if you don't think Elvis was the king, baby, I feel sorry for you. 'Cause if you don't think he was number one, you're full of number two.
Well, hell, Webb, even the Beatles, who could rock it right through the roof, probably be the first ones to admit wasn't an Elvis in the group.
Yeah, even old Bob Dylan knows the words to Moody Blue. So if you don't think he's number one, you're full of number two.
Yeah, if you don't think he was number one, then you're full of number two.
If you don't think Elvis was the king, baby, I feel sorry for you. Pick up on it.
Bless your heart, my little sweet patootie. Come on over here. Oh, my goodness, let me get a look at you. If I was 20 years younger, I'd tell you. My goodness.
Hello, Riley.
Spielberg.
Oh, excuse me.
Lights don't ever dim in the kind of bars that never close in the back of the game of T. Jim.
What's your deal with Antebellum Skin, Inc.?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't play dumb with me. You're paying those guys $5,000 a week, and I want to know why.
You're a dick.
Smile when you say that. Look, Mr. Movie Man, you can deal with me or answer to the DPS, and about half of them are here right now.
Okay, okay. Look, have some punch.
Spill it. Excuse me.
Wait.
Last night your shadow fell upon my lonely room. I touched your golden hair and tasted your perfume. Your eyes were filled with love the way they used to be. Your gentle hand reached out to comfort me. Then gave a dawn, and you were gone. You were gone, gone, gone. I had too much to dream last night. Too much to dream.
The time you came in off the Gumbo and Chitlin circuit?
29 gigs in 27 days. Picked up a bug in Baton Rouge.
You look worse this time.
Yeah, but back then I had you to make things better for me.
I didn't make you better. I just made things sane for you.
I could use some more of that.
Oh, Webb, I don't think that.
Wilder. Hold on. Hold on. Okay. Just wait there. Bye.
With my skull cracked and my mind blown, the governor's daughter's call reverberated in my addle-pated brain like a cherry bomb in a 50-gallon drum. But as the miasma cleared, the naked truth emerged. Horn goons don't dig art house movies, and they absolutely hate paying for them. Turns out, Antebellum Skin had paid Briley Parkway to make a blue movie, Junior League Nymphos. And he'd blown the whole wad, 100 grand, on his art monster breakthrough opus, Slug Trail. They wanted babes, he gave them bugs. Till now, he'd been paying them back from Kirsten's trust fund, but they were getting nervous and it looked like they'd settle for his hide. They dragged it out of Kirsten's apartment at dawn.
Carlsbad, Devereaux.
I made the first mistake. I said to myself, Carlsbad, this kid is an artist, an intellectual. He wants to make movies. I thought, hell, he can give Antebellum Skin Incorporated some class. A step towards something more legit. But I wasn't listening that close. You don't give a rat's tee-hiney about making movies. You want to make films! So it's my fault for being the hillbilly who didn't know the difference.
Look, I'm paying you back. Well, with interest.
You said a mouthful that time, Needlebutt. Interest in you's at an all-time high. Big Ike had to club your buddy Wilder yesterday, and that son of a bitch is working for the governor.
What?
He wanted to know about you and the business. Now, what the hell am I going to do about that?
What comes natural?
Lord help us. Webb, I wish you'd just forget all about this.
What happened, Carlsbad? What happened to the country boy singing his heart out on Clear Channel every Saturday night?
He got educated to what it's all about.
What about your career?
My career is a wax string hanging out of cat's ass. Oh, hell, they let me do that cable TV mess with Ralph, but you don't even have to be able to make a sentence to be on that thing.
Smut's better?
It's money for entertainment. How's it really any different?
There's some things I stand for. Some things I won't stand for. Briley's doing his thing. You're just diddling with yours.
Just relax, plowboy.
Boy,
you're dumber than a bucket of rocks.
Everybody freeze, I'm gonna pop a top on a tall boy can of whoop ass.
You wouldn't.
With a smile on my face.
Oh, Travis! Thank you so so much for helping us.
Don't thank me. Riley's the one that shut them guys down. Webb was right. Slug Trail was chock full of metaphor.
Hello? Oh, hi, Briley. Yeah, he's doing well. You know Webb. Yeah, I'll tell him. Bye. That was Briley. The shoot's going well. He and Kristen hope your back feels better soon.
That's nice.
You deserve it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Dr. Barbara.
What, honey?
You know what's wrong with my dreams.
No.
You're not in them.
Maybe we can fix that.
When I was in the cradle, Mama used to say to baby, don't you cry.
Ideas.